All right, Queen, we got all the foreplay out of the way a few minutes ago. Let's get into the meat.
Oh, wow. Let's do get into the meat. Burns, I love it. I did want to ask you guys something, because you guys know, you're in the know. 99 Next Morning Show, you guys know everything.
Hey,
you're the best.
We just went through this. It's the Morning X, Queen.
The Morning X. I'm sorry, you guys are in the know. Have you noticed in Atlanta, there are these eyes put up all over the city now. The people are, it's graphic, people with like spray paint all over the city. It's called that, and it's all over the internet now. It's called the Eyes of Atlanta. Have you done anything about that?
I've noticed the eyes, but I didn't know what it was about.
They think it's some kind of rock group that's about to announce their album.
They're using this promotional thing.
Some guy went across and blacked them all out, and they were back the next day. It's called the Eye. If you Google the Eyes of Atlanta, I thought for sure you knew what it was about.
No,
nothing.
Maybe one of our listeners will know.
Yes.
There's no talk of who.
No, there. No one will come forward, but there's scuttlebutt on the streets. It is some kind of famous rock band that's getting ready to announce like a new album.
All right.
It's exciting. Ooh,
story developing.
Research.
So, it's that time of the year. It's almost Halloween. The Netherworld Haunted House is back in Stone Mountain, which is, scary enough already going to Stone Mountain. Listen, all the tickets are timed and dated. Don't just show up. They will not let you in the door this year. So call ahead and, go to Stone Mountain. This is something that Crash Clark, remember he used to do every year? Fabulous listening to him do those. And I think you hear this group sometimes on the Steve Show, but I just like saying their names, Floggin' Molly. You know Floggin' Molly?
I've heard of them.
Every year.
They're at the Tabernacle on Friday night with their kind of Pogue Clash sounding in their Irish. You know I have Irish in my past. There's this town in Ireland that has my last name, girl. I'm just saying.
Killo.
Thank you. Saturday is the Heart Walk at Atlanta, at Atlantic Station. And, since I've lost weight, I'm starting to do sort of these outdoor things where you move and you walk, trying to raise $3 million for the American Heart Association. And you can bring your dogs to this. I love when they let you bring your dogs to these walking events. They're so cute. Tonight, head down to my favorite place in Atlanta, just southwest, Serenby. Oh, I love Serenby.
Serenby is so cool.
It is so cool. To their Wildflower Meadow, which I'm sure this place was founded by a bunch of rich potheads, because everything is named like Wildflower.
But nothing against Serenby, but Trilith said, hold my beer. Have you been to Trilith?
Love Trilith.
Yeah.
It's fabulous.
It's like a way amped up Serenby. And I like Serenby.
It really is.
But that was I went to Trilith for a lunch for the first time this week, and I was blown away by how great it was.
It's beautiful. So the thing at Serenby is called, I'm going to butcher this, but Fafadea and Company. It's sort of like a highbrow Cirque du Soleil outside, sort of like the Pink Show she had at Midtown, where she's flying all over Midtown in the park. They're kind of half naked, and they say they use inflatables. What the hell could that mean? What are they using inflatables for?
I don't know, but you just sold tickets just right there.
Exactly. tonight, Project Open Hand having their yearly fundraiser at the Stave Room in American Spirits. That's over on Armor Drive. If you've never been to the Stave Room for an event, fabulous, by the way. So basically, all the chefs in Atlanta getting together. Kevin Rathbun this year is the head chef.
Oh my God,
he is great. Basically, you get to eat all night long. They get you liquored up, and then there is a charity auction. This is like weekends in Paris, and this fabulous stuff, Barnes. Stuff you would go to.
Well, they liquor you up first on purpose, Queen. Swipe that card. Mm-hmm.
Of course they do. The reason I'm talking about this event, besides that, love Project Open Hand. Girls are always saying, "Hey, Gay Bob, how do I meet men?" This is how you meet men. This is what you go to. Put on a nice dress, beat your face. This is how you single guys. I'm telling
you. Here's your tip.
Beat your face?
Beat your face, girl. That's what you put nice makeup on. They call it beating your face.
Oh.
Oh, come on.
Queen, I'm sorry. I don't know that.
Now you're on the inside of the gay world. Just saying.
Is that just for the gay side? Or when I go in,
it's
like...
It's more drag queenie, but you can say beat your face.
Drag queenie.
Leslie's face is always beat for
if
every
I walk
show.
In and Heather's getting ready, if I say, hey, you beating your face? She's going to know what I mean.
Exactly what
She's
you're talking
not gonna
about.
She's not going to know.
Okay.
I think so.
She's pretty cool, that Heather. She'll probably know. Friday through Sunday, the Braves are at Truist with the Nationals, Washington Nationals. You know, every time I talk about them, I remember that's when I saw Dave Justice naked when they was playing. Remember Jimmy let me go down to the... That's a good play from the past, by the way.
Jimmy let you go down and see Dave Justice naked.
Took me down to the Braves thing in the meeting.
To the locker room?
Into the locker room.
The thing.
Ah. Oh, my God. Let's just say Dave Justice is not Jewish. Here, let's All right, Disney on Ice is at the Gaslight South in Gwinnett all this weekend. Let's see. There's talk of MAGA people protesting the Disney shows. Isn't that fantastic? And they may not show up because it's Gwinnett County, but, you know, Disney ice skaters are the gayest thing in the world, more than a Keller Williams real estate agent. That's how gay Disney ice skaters are.
Who are you trouncing there?
Jimmy Barron. It's pretty gay as a real estate agent.
He was great on television talking about Elton's condo for sale.
He was great, but couldn't they give him a telephone book to sit on? Did you see his little head barely got in the frame?
I don't even know how they got him to stick with the technology, because we can never, when we have him on our show, it's like 50,000 hours to get him connected. I don't even know how they got him connected in time for the newscast.
Bless his heart. Friday night. He did look good, though. But, you know, next time a telephone book is just shrinking. Bless his heart.
Just say.
Last but not least, Emo Orchestra is at a 99X show at Symphony Hall this Sunday. And they have a special guest, Hawthorne Heights. Basically, it's a rock band covered by a symphony. And it's all the rage, girl. Everybody's doing it. Everybody's doing these emo things lately with a symphony orchestra.
I don't know what emo is back.
It is bad.
It all comes around. All right, Queen. That's a busy weekend. Thank you for the report.
Busy. All right, girl.
Good morning. X with Barnes and Leslie.